God's always there, ready to help you, to support you, and this is the point of sharing things with you. And that's why you are here today. That's why we're glad that you are here today. Never forget that.
This is Logan. What could he possibly talk about?
I was one of those kids who did real well in high school without having to work too hard. I got to Carnegie Mellon University. I mean, everybody at Carnegie Mellon University was the smartest kid in their class, and they all worked hard, right? So the worse I did, the unhappier I got, and the happier I got, the worse I did.
But I wanted to let you know that the journey started when I was your age.
So I left school my junior year, joined the Marine Corps, spent 4 years in the Marine Corps, traveled halfway around the world, came back to college, did much better, graduated. So college graduate, college dropout, former Marine, cradle Catholic, Roman Catholic, born into the church, baptized as a baby, right? Confirmed at 8th, 9th grade. About the time I graduated high school and left home, quit going to church. Really didn't have much time, energy, attention for church, the Lord, religion. Wasn't a high priority in the Marines.
Any of you think you're getting a call or even thinking about something within our church that you don't wait as long as I do?
It wasn't until I got out of the Marine Corps, went back to school, met my wife, graduated, and she and I were married, that she said I need to belong to a church. And it was in that process that I went back and started to rediscover my faith.
Memory, I got this feeling. Question to the leaders for me, ask them what them dealing. She said that the world need a spiritual healing. What about the youths that believe in? Cyberspace tech with the mind, only that them are believing. The elders get bitter, so them stop from teaching. Minds from the youth, then how you are gonna reach him? Tell me how you are gonna reach him. We remembering the past, but if there wasn't no past, just remember, say there wouldn't be no future.
So I'm breathing in your grace and breathing out your praise. I'm breathing in your grace forever only. Breathing in your grace and breathing out your praise. I'm breathing in your grace forever only. Breathing in your grace and breathing out your praise.
Hello, oh, oh, oh. It doesn't are talking about growing this weekend and about the seeds that fell on the different types of soil. But right now, we're going to take it out of that scripture context, and we just want you all to grow together as a group of friends.
Come on, Nate, do it.
Come on, Mika, you can do it.
Woo!
Shrinking back into this world, back into ourselves. Therefore, we must reach our arms and branch out like trees. We must outgrow this world and be replanted into the firm soil of Christ.
It's gonna be a long, long journey. It's gonna be an uphill climb. It's gonna be a tough fight. It's gonna be some lonely nights. But I'm ready to carry on. I'm so glad the worst is over. I can start living now. Ooh, I feel I can do anything, yeah. And finally, I'm not afraid to breathe. Anything you say to me, and everything you do, you can't deny the truth, 'cause I'm the living proof. So many don't survive, they just I'm the living proof. Oh, yes, I am. Thinking back, life's been painful. Yes, it was. Took a while to learn how to smile. So now I'm gonna talk to my people about the storm, about the storm. So glad the worst is over. I can stop flying now. Oh, my death day's right in front of me. And I'm almost there. 'Cause now I'm free.